Good morning.
Morning, hi everyone.
So, since I'm going to be a teacher today, okay.
Wow,
I'm
professor.
So, today I will teach you how to read in Italian.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's something super easy, and at least when you go to an Italian restaurant, you know how to say properly the name.
Yeah, pizza.
So we start with the alphabet, okay?
Yeah.
Alphabet A. Oh well, let's start with the vowel first.
Oh, are you going fancy?
Yeah. So these are the vowels. I read A.
A.
I. O. U. Super simple.
Should I repeat because I don't know them?
Yeah. You go.
A. E, I, O, U.
Perfect.
Giusto.
There are no exceptions, okay? They are always like this. Never change. Never, ever, ever, okay?
Okay.
So, alphabet. A. B.
B.
C.
Just like English. B.
C.
C.
D.
D.
E. F. G, H, I,
how do you remember all those things?
L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, Z. Okay? Now you read it.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, L, M, N, O, P,
C,
Q,
no. C,
Q,
C.
Okay.
R. The tongue is on the upper part of your
mouth. It is there. Yes. Doesn't do the thing.
Okay.
R. S. T. U. V.
V.
V. V.
V.
Wait, what is the other one? U. V.
U. V.
Ah, U. V. Z. No. Z. V.
Zeta.
Zeta.
Zeta. Do you notice that something is missing?
Yeah, there should be something missing. I can't know.
We don't have J, K, W, X, Y. Yeah. Because, like, we have the sound to describe those letters. So it's J, K, W, Y, X. But we use it just with foreigner words, like yogurt, which is a Greek word, or xylophono, or something like this, like really specific words that comes from ancient Greek or this kind of word. So we don't use it in the alphabet. So how do you read Italian? There are few exceptions in the language, which are with the C and with the G. These two letters. Okay? So, with these two letters, you should read ka, ke, ki, ko, ku. But these two, if you put the C near to the I, it becomes CE. So it's ka, CE, CI, CO, CU. To read CE, you have to put the H. So it's ka, CE, CI, CO, CU. Ka, CE, CI, CO, CU. The same thing is for the G. So it's ga, ge, gi, go, gu. Ga, ge, gi, go, gu. So G, ge, gi. You have to put the H to have a stronger sound. Okay? You try.
Ka, ka, che, chi, ko, ku. Ka, ke, ki, ko, ku. Ga, ge, gi.
Okay, you read like this. Okay, you read like this.
Ga, ge, gi, go, ku, gu. Ga, je, ji, go, gu.
Perfect. So, there are two other exception in the reading, which are two sounds. Is with these two sounds. One is GN, which is read ny.
Ny.
Like lasagne.
Lasagne.
Okay. I'll write the example. La. Za.
Ny. Ny. The tongue is pushing upward. Ny. Pushing the ceiling of your mouth.
Yeah. And you have to read every letter and every vowels. There are no cases where you don't read the letters or vowels or anything. Like la za nie. You read the
e. Okay. Eh, la za nie.
And then this other sound is li.
Ye.
Like if you studied French, it's the same as double L, fille.
Double L?
Yeah. In French is this. Double L. Lieu, you can use it in the word. Okay, always related to food.
Oh, it's like in Spanish. Spanish, los pollos.
Yeah. Okay. The word tagliatelle.
Tagliatelle.
Yeah, there's a yeah.
Yeah.
So yeah, I think that now you're able to read a perfect Italian. That's it. You just have to read
all the
letter.
I can speak
it's
Italian.
So
now.
Simple.
Wonderful.
I can tell you about some exception for a word, like this word, which means heaven, is one of the few words where you have to put the E before the E. So it's, you read it cello, but it's not written C-E, but C-E-E.
Wait, how do you pronounce it?
Cello.
So it's, you don't pronounce the
it's
E?
It's like there wasn't any
really?
E, but it's one of the few words, like maybe there are three in all the Italian.
I didn't know.
I actually don't know any other word. And then there's another sound you should, I was forgetting, you should take care of, which is sh. So this is another linguistic exception. Is sha, she, shi, sho, shu.
Sha, she, shi, sho, shu.
Yeah. If you.
That's it.
Like sha for shame, shemo, shimya, shoko, shu. I don't know any word.
Shu.
No, it's not the shu. Yeah, this is another exception.
Mm.
And then what else? Yeah, now we'll let you read. Like I will write something.
Some examples.
So, no, better. I will take a book and you will read. You read the title, okay?
I read?
Yeah.
La Masai Bianca. Storia vera di una passione africana.
See, you read all the letters. There are no exceptions. It's super easy. L-A, la. M-A-S-A-I Masai B-I-A-N-C-A Bianca. It's so easy. So yeah, that's it.
That's it
yeah,
for
that's
the
it.
Italian. So now you know how to speak Italian, just like me.
Yeah. So, the the okay, let's read some food name, okay?
Yeah.
So
some examples. Lasagne. It's never A, is only it's E.
Wait.
Or is plural.
Wait.
You're right.
Okay, these three. I think that these are the more urgent for me because every time that I hear a person, a foreigner reading this word, they're always wrong.
How can they make a mistake on panini?
Because in Italian, it changed the final part of. Like the final vowel, sometimes there are exceptions, of course, but panini, it means that it's more than one, and often in native English person say I ate a one panini, but if it's one, it's a panino.
That's the grammar.
It's grammar. Lasagna is a whole dish, like I'm eating lasagna, because lasagna is made of more than one lasagna, which is the kind of pasta.
Oh.
So you are eating a dish of lasagna, which is more than one. So you never eat, I ate one lasagna, because it means that you ate a piece of pasta. So.
But when you go to a restaurant, order lasagna.
Yeah,
lasagna. You order lasagna.
Si,
order lasagna.
Lasagna.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I always say
and
lasagna.
When you go in a bar and you're asking for having this, you want a panino. Oh, not a panini, because it means that you are ordering more than one.
Wait, a?
Un panino.
Why do you say a?
Because I'm using English and Italian. They always read linguini because this in English is E, but it's linguine because in Italian is E.
What is this?
It's a kind of pasta.
Oh.
Okay.
I thought it was tongue.
Yeah, the other thing about, well, this is actually more about culture, but pasta is a generic. It's a generic word that identify just the pasta. Like how is made with grano, wheat,
yeah,
with the wheat, the water, and there are just two distinctions. One is pasta with egg, and then is pasta without egg. Pasta with egg, you have to eat it faster because since there's egg, it goes bad easily and faster. Pasta without egg, you can use it. Even in after 1 year, it will last forever because it's dry. But the thing is that the name linguine, lasagne, fusilli, pennette, it's always the same pasta, like it's always the same ingredient inside. It just changed the shape. It's not like I'm eating fusilli and it got a different flavor from pennette. Like, if you put it in your mouth, both the taste is the same because it's the same thing, you just change the shape. So, we have this because with some sauce, it's easier to use a kind of pasta. Like, with pennette, it's easier to use tomato sauce because it goes inside the pennetta and make it yummy. Like, it's the shape made for a different sauce. So it's more convenient to put the thing inside. And yeah, that was interesting, I think, because people, maybe somebody, I heard that, oh, I really like farfalle more than pennette. And I'm like, no, you like more the sauce that is in farfalle than the one that is in pennette, because the pasta is exactly the same.
Maybe they like the shape more.
Yeah, maybe, yeah. No, but she was talking about the taste. Uh-huh. She was like, oh yeah, I feel it more savory and stuff. And I was like, No, it's exactly the same. Yeah. So, That's it. That's really it.
Italian food and alphabet.
Hope it has been useful and interesting for you. I don't know if you are planning to learn some Italian. If you do, I'm really happy.
Yeah. She can be your teacher.
Yeah, I wish I could, but I'm not. So, yeah, see you next week.
See ya.
Bye bye.